heart, which is here in the cavity, it will be pumped. Okay? So your, if your server is not hard and flat, the effectiveness will be less. Okay? Yes. Yes. Secondly, your thigh level should be at the level of the chest. Because if patient is very high, I will not be able to do that. Right? If he is on a table or bed, or you can go to the table. Like in emergency, we have patient on the stretchers. We have footrest, which we keep down. Or very tall people can do like this. Okay? Or we go to the patient's bedside. If it is a bed, I will be like this. Okay? So your thigh level should be at the chest level. This is the positioning. Right? You can expose the patient. Third thing is landmark, where you have to keep your hands. Okay? So rough landmark is between the nipple line you can keep. Okay? So between the nipple line in the center, you can keep your hands. Right? So, like she has already told you, one hand, the heel, you should keep in the center of the nipple line. Right? Like this. Second hand should come over and grip the first hand. Come over to the patient, not from here. Okay? So if you do from here, you will be like this. Come over to the patient, right, and start the compressions. So you have to go 2 or 2.5 inches down. It should be hard and fast. Okay, so it should be hard and fast. Now you know how to do, where to do, when to. Okay, so how long to do, right? So 30 compressions you have done, right? You have to count loudly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 30 compressions you have done. After that, what we should do? See. Fascia. Face muscle. Okay. Big muscle. It's okay. This will be in hospital, not with you. It will not be available with you on the roadside. So she has given 30 compressions. So now she will give 2 breaths. First you have to make the airway patent. The lung has fallen down back. So we have to make it patent, open the airway. How you will do it? Put the palm on the head of the patient and 2 fingers on the chin. So you will flex like this and open the airway. So that the tongue which is fallen back will come forward and the airway becomes patent. So this is called head tilt and chin lift. You have to do this. Then put the mask or the face shield and give 2 breaths. First you take deep breath and
breathe in.
here seal your mouth with patient's mouth. Okay, so that whatever air you are blowing into the patient should not come out. And pinch the nose. Okay, why we are pinching?
It should not come out.
Yes, so whatever air you are giving should not come out from nose, it should go into the lungs. Okay, so like this we are compressing heart so that heart should pump, but where will we get oxygen? So like this we are giving oxygen. Okay, job done. Compressing heart, giving oxygen. Compressing heart, giving oxygen. 30 times if you do this and 2 times if you do this, that is called one cycle. Okay, that is one cycle. 30 compressions, 2 breaths. How long will you take to give 2 breaths?
Quarter of a second.
So 1 breath should be given over 1 second. 2 breaths over 2 seconds. So ideally your breath should be given over 2 seconds. Okay? And 30 compressions with 2 seconds you will give 2 breaths. Correct? Now 30 is to 2 is the ratio. That is 1 cycle. You have to do this 5 times. So it means when you do 5 cycles, after 5 cycles you have done, what will you do?
Check for the response.
Yes. Not response, you can check for the pulse again. Okay? So every 2 minutes or every 30:5 ratio for 5 times when you do, after 5 times you will check this pulse. If pulse is there, you can lay, patient will be still unconscious. Okay? You can lie down, the patient in the recovery position as I told you. But if this pulse is not there, again you will continue the CPR. Okay? CPR will continue. Okay? So 30:2, 5 times, that will be approximately 2 minutes. So every 2 minutes you will check the pulse. Pulse is there, patient in recovery position, or you continue till the help arrives or ambulance arrives. Correct? CPR is a very tiring job. It's really very tiring. When you will practice, you will realize it's still a mannequin. When you are doing it a live option, it's a very tiring. Except if you are not tired, you are not giving effective CPR. Okay, it is not like this. Many times people have asked at many programs questions, what if patient's ribs are broken? What will patient's ribs are broken?
Hospital.
See, let it be broken. You want a live patient or you want a broken patient? See, live patient is more good than intact. Okay? If patient is not there, what do you do with the ribs? Okay? So, if you break the ribs also, no problem. There is no surgery for ribs. If ribs are broken also, nothing we do. Okay? We put it conservatively, it gets equal. Right? So, your CPR should be hard and fast. Don't think that some click has happened and you have broken the ribs. Don't think, no problem. If you are doing effective CPR, definitely you will break the ribs. It is breakthrough. Okay? So, give effective CPR. It is said you should do 100 per minute. 100 compressions you should do per minute. Okay? So, if you 100 do per minute in 1 second, how much you should do? 1 second.
So,
more than 1 you have to do, right? In 1 second you have to do more than 1 compression. That, like that you will reach 100 per minute. It should be so fast, okay? 100 per minute is the rate at which you should do the compressions. It should be very, very fast, okay? And when you are seeing the pulse, you have pulse for 2 minutes you have done, okay? You are checking again for pulse. How long will you check? Less than 10 seconds. Okay, less than 10 seconds you have to check. Because why the CPR, this interruptions should be minimum? Why? Why is CPR interruptions when we are doing, when we are checking the pulse? Why it should be very, very minimum? Because whatever you are compressing the heart, all the blood supply is going to the brain. Okay, so brain is functioning. You will have lot of interruptions in the CPR, again heart will stop and again brain is not getting blood supply, brain will be compromised. Okay? So this is the importance, this is the indication, this is the way how a CPR is done. Okay? You will be able to do it, you will practice. I just want to show you AED. draw this AD and tell you what is the film. Okay? This is a Malik machine. It will tell you each and everything what you have to do. Okay? Like she told you, know, you will call ambulance and tell, bring an AD. If you find this AD, you can use it. But in India, very rare places have these. Many MNCs are having. Microsoft is having this. TCS is having this. Went to TCS recently, 6 months back. They are having the same. Okay? It's a little expensive device, so everybody cannot afford. But in foreign lands, you will find AD in public places. Okay? So if you get AD, well and good. If you're not, okay. This is called automated external defibrillator. Okay? AED. Name is not important. Automated, it is auto. It will tell you each and every. External from outside. Defibrillator is shock. Okay? So it is automated external defibrillator. What it will do? Have you seen in movies they give shock? So when patient is in cardiac arrest, there are some rhythms, not all. There are some rhythms which will require shock. Okay? Actually, those are called dancing rhythms of heart. Okay? Dancing rhythm means heart has to pump like this, correct? For blood supply to go up. But in this dancing rhythm, heart is contracting like this. It is not contracting like this. It is contracting like this. So what happens? It is not able to pump the blood. Okay? It is just contracting and dancing. It is not doing us anything good. Okay? So these rhythms have to be stopped. And how we stop these rhythms? By shock. Okay? We stop these rhythms and we do manual CPR and start up. But you don't have to go into the details. When heart is dancing, how we will know, what we will do. No. Okay? This machine is for, not for doctors. This is for basic people, common people who are not doctors, okay? Who are not in medical. So what you will do is as you get an AED, actually this machine recognizes for you that whether patient requires shock or not. Okay? This machine recognizing for you. So as soon as you get this AED or you have this AED in your place, how does it function? So suppose she has brought AED for me. I'm doing CPR. She has brought AED. I'm very fortunate. I have the access to AED. So what I will do for every machine, what I will do? Switch off. Very good. There are different models of AED. All steps would be written. 1, 2, 3. Everything would be written in very good. Okay? So switch on. First of all, you will everything will tell you. Just listen carefully. Okay? So I am on it. I am just, see this is just a demo machine. This is not actually. Okay. So what I will do is, I will just on it. Battery.
Okay.